For Expert Village, I'm Kurt for N7QJM. Now, don't be too nervous if you're taking the exam. It's like any other test. You can take it again if you have to. So where would you take these exams? If you don't succeed, well, hey, try again, like I said. Well, back to our other question, where would you take these? Well, there are volunteer examiners throughout the country, and they are basically volunteering to help you become a ham radio operator. So what you'll need to do is arrange a time, or I suppose first find where they are, then secondly, arrange a time to go and take the test, and thirdly, go ahead and show up for the examination and take the examination. Now, once you establish yourself and you pass the examination, then what you do is you go to the volunteer examiner. They'll have you sign some paperwork, and then they'll send that off to the FCC. And it usually takes between 4 and maybe 12 weeks for you to actually get your ticket or your ham radio license at the point. Congratulations, though, on taking it, and congratulations on passing. I took it the first time, passed it the first time. I did a good job of studying, and if you watched the previous sessions, you would be able to do that. One final note, that if you wanted to have some sort of, you've probably seen these on cars, those are called vanity plates, and they have their call letters usually on there. You can actually make that a reality as well. Just contact your local DOL, the Department of Licensing, and they'll do it from there. Short session this time. We'll see you the next time where we're actually starting to set up the ham rig. Till then, N7QJM, 73s.